According to the bill, an assault weapon is a semi-automatic firearm with detachable magazines that has at least two of the following features: a telescoping stock, a folding stock, a pistol grip that protrudes beneath the action of the weapon, a thumb hole stock, a bayonet mount, a threaded barrel to accommodate a flash suppressor, muzzle brake, or compensator, or a grenade launcher. A telescoping stock allows the rifle to be custom sized to the shooter. It's good for small shooters, medium-sized shooters, and large shooters. Also allows the guns to be customized when the clothing changes, such as a heavy winter coat during hunting. This does not affect the function of the firearm in any way. A folding stock makes the rifle easier to transport because it fits into a smaller case. In practicality, though, it doesn't make it any more concealable. A pistol grip that protrudes beneath the action of the weapon is simply a method to hold the firearm. If the firearm did not have a pistol grip, you would simply grip the stock. Pistol grip? No pistol grip. Whether a firearm has a pistol grip or not does not affect the function in any way, nor does it affect its accuracy. A thumb hole stock is nothing more than a stock with a pistol grip that's attached to the stock. With a bayonet lug, you can mount a bayonet to a rifle. In my 35 years of gun ownership, I have never heard of a single crime being committed with a rifle-mounted bayonet. A threaded barrel is designed to accommodate either a flash hider, a muzzle brake, or compensator. A flash hider simply reduces the amount of light that comes out of the barrel when firing and has no effect on function. A compensator or muzzle brake is designed to reduce the recoil of the firearm. However, these guns have so little recoil that it really has no practical value and does not affect function. In regards to grenade launchers, there's absolutely no grenades available for civilian purchase. The launchers are restricted to smoke and flares. These are emergency signaling devices as used by boaters. None of the cosmetic features of this firearm make it any different than any other firearm. Take this one as an example. It has none of the features that would be banned under the proposed bill, yet it fires the same exact ammunition with the same capacity magazine. Another example would be this rifle, which is perfectly legal under the proposed ban as it has none of those cosmetic features. However, if you take it out of the factory stock, and put it into another stock that has a collapsible buttstock and a pistol grip, this rifle now becomes illegal. There's no reason to ban this class of firearms, as there's no difference between these and other firearms.